23ABC's digital update is brought to you by West Medical.
Good evening, I'm Jessica Harrington. Here's what's making headlines around Kern County. Local health officials say the county is moving in the right direction when it comes to getting off the state's monitoring list. Public Health Director Matt Constantine said although the county didn't meet most of the triggers that determine when that might happen, he did say once that day comes, it still wouldn't mean that certain businesses could automatically reopen in some capacity.
So if the county comes off of the monitoring list, the restrictions the governor placed back in mid-July still stand. So although these counties are coming off, the restrictions to indoor restaurants and indoor hair salons still apply.
Constantine said the county is still not meeting certain triggers or metrics, positive case rates and hospitalizations. He also claims the numbers released each day are now closer to real-time results, but that does not include the COVID deaths. We're getting our first look inside the new Amazon Fulfillment Center right here in Kern County. City and county officials visited the site this morning with representatives from Amazon for a ribbon cutting before a tour inside the facility. The worldwide e-commerce company says the facility is called a fulfillment center because it's where everything from manufacturer inventory to the direct shipping will take place. The center will be located near the Meadows Field Airport and will provide at least 2,000 jobs in Kern County. Sales at Target are really booming amid the pandemic. The retailer said sales at its stores open for at least 1 year grew more than 24% between May and July. That marks the strongest quarterly sales growth in Target's history. Online delivery and curbside pickup were a highlight for the company, rising 195% during the quarter. Big box chains like Target and Walmart have thrived during the pandemic. They were deemed essential retailers and stayed open to offer groceries, household essentials, clothes, and other merchandise.
And believe it or not, our sky's even smokier today compared to yesterday. You can see those dark shades of gray, thick smoke all across, especially central and western Kern County. Really, the worst impacts are going to be in the valley areas where we've seen air quality hit level 5 on the real-time air advisory network. That's as high as it goes. That is very unhealthy air that we're seeing right now. So air quality alert remains in effect really kind of indefinitely until all the wildfires across the state are extinguished. It's really hard to predict when the air quality is going to get better because it's driven so much by the fires that are burning in addition to the weather. And looking forward to tomorrow, we do have a component of a north-northwest wind that's going to bring in plenty of smoke again. So these hazy skies, this very poor air quality likely to persist for us tomorrow. The smoky skies, though, have kept us a little bit cooler here. We're looking at 100 in Bakersfield for tomorrow, so we've kind of curved the temperatures down because we're not seeing as much sunlight due to the smoke. 92 in Tehachapi, still very hot in the desert though, not as smoky out there. 110 in Ridgecrest. 7-day forecast again. I've kind of curved the temperatures down a little bit through the entire forecast. I think we're going to kind of hover right around 100 degrees, so it's possible we could actually break out of our heat wave thanks to this wildfire smoke, also including a small chance for some showers Sunday into Monday. A little better chances for those showers going to be in our mountain communities. And again, you see temperatures are cooling off a little bit as we head into next week.
That's your latest news and weather update. For the latest news anytime, be sure to log on to our website, turn to 23.com.